The motorcycles built by William Harley and Arthur Davidson have become synonymous with the free and open American road. Hi, my name is Joe Kelly Jr., and on this special two-wheeled edition of Playing with Cars, we're going to be looking at Diecast Promotions 1/12 scale Harley Cruisers. Stick around, these things are bad to the bone. Harley Davidson made their first V-twin powered motorcycle in 1909. The little 7 horsepower engine really had to work hard to top the bike out at a screaming 60 miles per hour. Now that basic architecture has stayed the same, but the bikes have grown a lot. Harley is now the undisputed cruising king of the American highway. So what happens when this icon meets Diecast Promotions modeling know-how? Come on, I'll show you. Anyone familiar with Highway 61 won't be surprised at the amount of operating features on this model. There's a working suspension up in the front and at the rear, a rubber drive belt that moves along with the rear tire, a posable kickstand, a shift lever that'll actuate this rod alongside the engine, that's pretty neat, these fold-up footrests for the passenger, and a foot brake over on the other side. Now, those really aren't doing anything, but they move as they would on the real bike, and they're neat little spring-loaded mechanisms. There's also opening hard luggage on the bikes. And on these full-dress road kings, another neat feature for display option, a removable seat back and a pop-off windshield. But by far, my favorite bit of business on the bike are these tiny little hand grips. Again, they're not doing anything, but they're spring-loaded. Somebody went through a little bit of trouble to put them on there, and the trouble pays off in an interesting little detail. Diecast Promotions has done a great job putting these big Harleys out in scale. The bikes are jammed with operating features and loaded with great detailing, and their paint and build quality rate an 8 out of 10. Now that being said, two of the 6 bikes that came in for review did have some chrome issues, but one of those two was a factory hand sample of a model that's not even in production yet. If you're a Harley collector of any stripe, I think you're going to find these models to be a great value, and that's something we've come to expect from this manufacturer over the years. I recommend them highly. I also recommend highly that you come back and see us again soon. It's been a lot of fun putting this first edition of Playing with Cars together. So until we meet again, my name is Joe Kelly Jr. Remember, there's always room for one more. Take care. We'll see you around. Bye-bye.
Okay, Dad.